They find a number of snakes in the mud trying to escape the intense heat. But no females. Only a lot of belligerent males.
I!
You have been had.
Welcome to the club.
That's nice. That's what my husband has to say about this. Welcome to the club. I have to say that does not hurt as much as a tetanus shot.
That's right.
Definitely not.
That's exactly right.
So did you tell me there's no snake catchers who get bitten once? Either zero times or 20.
What a temper.
They do find one lone female.
Oh, my lord.
Yeah,
hold your tail. You're gonna grab me here. This is an example of problems anacondas get. This is a very large girl, but she's very skinny. And the reason might be because she has a bad mouth infection. Horrible mouth infection. She's got a growth of work. Oh, she's not even capable. We've never seen a snake this big enough. She has infection below the teeth, the lower jaw, and she has a piece of bone sticking out here. Seems that the mandible was broken in two, and one part is there. It's a solid, it's a bony structure there. And she might have had this wound for probably quite a long time. That's why she's so skinny. She's shedding, which is a good sign. They do that to recover from wounds and stuff. She's fighting back, she's not giving up on it. She was in a very warm water, which is what they do to fight infections. They give them some fever. She hasn't eaten in a long time, obviously. That's why she's so skinny. And this horrible mouth infection. She doesn't heal her mouth soon enough so she can't eat it. Then she probably won't make it. I have seen anacondas survive wounds as bad as this in the mouth. But she's not a goner. They are extremely tough animals, and she might recover from this one. We just better let nature be.
The future for this snake is not good. If she swims away, the birds mob her. One of these birds would make a good meal, but with her injury and weakened condition, hunting would prove impossible for her. The search for a breeding female has resulted in finding a lot of snakes, but all of them male.
It's a boy, isn't it? Oh, thank you.
Anacondas have a temper and can be hard to handle. It certainly seems to be true of the males they're finding.
It was a piece of me.
In hopes that a male will lead them to a breeding ball, Jesus and Sarah have decided to insert several with transmitters. Inserting a battery-powered inert resin cartridge containing two AA batteries, the transmitter's enclosed antenna will allow Jesus and Sarah to track the males as they search for a female.
4646. Well, that should be easy to remember. Let me hold the head so it's easy to remember.
Weighing over 2.5 ounces and measuring about 6 inches, the transmitter will eventually pass unchanged through the snake. Even with the anaconda's strong digestive juices.
Looks like it's a big meal, but this guy swallows a lot bigger things than this, so it's not really anything too bad for him to do this. It goes down smoothly.
Radio telemetry is a tremendous aid for wildlife biologists, enabling them to track the most elusive wildlife in hostile environments.
It's going down nice and smoothly.
Because of the snake's unique anatomy, traditional external tracking devices like collars or tags don't work. The transmitter must be internal. The transmitter's small size will not trigger digestion, and because anacondas eat infrequently, it will stay in the snake for several weeks.
So now it. Go find some doors.
Anacondas like shallow water to form their mating balls. The large lagoon in El Cedrón has too much water. Searching for prior emissions, Jesus, Sarah, and Victor travel to Mato El Frio, another ranch and wildlife preserve about 40 miles away. The environment there is much different. It's definitely drier, and their chances of finding a large female to implant improve greatly. After much searching, scaring them, as they travel in the open, searching for a receptive female. This is where their smaller size can be a plus. With each flick of their tongue, the males pick up the female's irresistible perfume. This perfume, called a pheromone, is a scent or odor produced by a female anaconda that lets the males know she's ready to mate. It's unclear if female anacondas only leave this scent as they crawl, or if males also pick up the scent from particles in the air. The result gives new meaning to group sex as multiple males coil around a single female. While wrapping tightly around them,
mating is a very amazing ritual.
Despite the uneven sex ratio, no conflicts or antagonistic interactions occur between the males. It's more of a pushing tournament. In a final attempt to ensure his sperm will succeed, the male implants the female with a white mass of protein and sperm to block her vent. This sperm plug lasts only a couple of days and might not prevent her from being courted by others who will make similar attempts. When the breeding ball breaks apart, the female and all the males go off on their own.
Here.
Then it's a mad dash to collect the males for their DNA. takes hours to round up all the snakes from the mating ball.
This is a capture from 3 years, 2 years ago, right?
Analyzing the data they've gathered will add another layer of information to their study.
Right now, for the parentage testing, we really have to develop DNA markers that are just for anacondas. It's never been done before.
One of the things that I enjoy the most of working with the snakes is when I get to put the snake back into the wild where they belong.
In about 7 months, this anaconda will give birth to 20 to 60 live young. The mother does not eat during her entire pregnancy because it makes her too vulnerable to predators.
When the anaconda breeds, she does not feed in all the 7 months the pregnancy lasts. So it's very important that she has a lot of fat reserves, a lot of fat storage in order to have healthy babies.
The months of pregnancy put such stress on her body that by the time she gives birth, she's basically. Some Hottos and Mianos have given anacondas and other local wildlife like capybara, caiman, and the endangered Orinoco crocodile protection. But like most snakes, anacondas still fall victim to human prejudice and ignorance.
The main enemy of anacondas is by far humans. A lot of people hate anacondas, they fear them, they kill them on sight just because they don't like them.
That's anaconda heaven.
This undercover footage shows that today, in many parts of South America, anacondas are still illegally hunted for skin and for the production of traditional medicines. In the 1980s, it was estimated that 29,000 anacondas per year were killed for the leather trade. Like other giant predators, its world is shrinking, and without protection, it could be
anacondas are in the appendix 2 of CITES. That means that they are relatively endangered. They are under protection. Even though they might be abundant in some places, they are under pressure. Because people kill their game. When people hunt the capybara, the deer, the caiman, then the anaconda is no longer have food.
One of the biggest problems we're having in conservation right now is this low genetic diversity can be potentially dangerous, especially given that we have all these human-caused changes in the environment. We really don't know how anacondas are going to be able to cope with it. They may not have enough tools in their evolutionary toolbox to be able to quickly go with the changes in the environment.
Just as science is getting a better grasp on their behavior, snake populations are declining in places where they used to flourish. It'll take Sarah and Jesus years of fieldwork to collect all the necessary data to assess the anaconda's future. The mystery that surrounds this giant snake continues to fascinate and stimulate our imagination. As the world faces a future where mega predators' numbers are in serious decline, the anaconda represents something ancient and mythic, a link back in time to when giant beasts roamed.